I'm going to show you the fastest possible way to get started with an entirely free hosted Postgres database. We're going to use Superbase, which has this lovely UI for quickly building out a schema, but gives you direct access to the underlying Postgres instance for any amount of complex tinkering or query optimization that you could dream of. We're also going to look at some super powerful AI features that can save you heaps of time. So let's get into it. Start by heading over to database.new and signing in with GitHub or any of these other methods. I'm going to call my project to-do-base because this is going to be a to-do list with Superbase. I'm going to click here to generate a secure password. Make sure you copy this somewhere like a password manager. But if you forget, don't worry about it. You can reset this database password at any time. Now let's choose a region that's close to our users. I'm the only user of this, so I'm going to select Sydney. And then let's click here to create our new project. And while our project is spinning up, these are the credentials that we'd use if we wanted to connect this to something like a Next.js app. So now that this is up and running, we can go to settings, and then under API, we can see our URL and our non-key from earlier. And under database, we can see our connection string if we wanted to connect something like Prisma or another Postgres client directly. And this is also where we would reset our database password if we didn't copy and paste that to a password manager. So if we head over to the table editor, we can use the UI to build out our schema. So we can click here to create a new table. We can give it the name to-dos. We'll leave row level security enabled, but we'll come back to this soon. For our columns, we can leave ID and created at, and then add another column for the title of our to-do. And the data type for this one is going to be text. And then let's click this cog and turn off is nullable because we want every to-do to have a title. And then let's add another column for an author. And we'll click this little chain link thing here to set up a relationship to another table. The schema for this one is going to be auth. The table we want to reference is going to be users. And the column is going to be ID. The auth.users table is a special Superbase table that we don't really need to worry about, but it just stores all of our users and information about their sessions. And then we can click save to set up that relationship and then save again to create that table. So we could keep using the UI to insert some rows into our to-dos table, or we could write this as raw SQL and run it in the SQL editor. So let's say insert into to-dos table, and we're just going to specify the title. And then for our values, we can specify our first to-do and then our second to-do and super creatively a third to-do. And we'll get rid of that dangling comma. Now we can click run to execute this or command enter, and we see success, no rows returned. So no errors means everything's all good. So let's select back our to-dos. We'll add a semicolon to this one because we're going to have multiple statements. And then we're going to say select star from to-dos and put a semicolon on there too. Now, if we highlight over just this one statement, you can see we would be running selected if we did command enter rather than everything in this query. So the insert as well as the select. So let's run just the select and we get back our three to-dos. Now, currently we don't have any authors because if we go over to authentication and then users, we can see we don't have any users in our project. So we can add a new user. We could send an invitation if this was a real user that we wanted to invite to our application, but we're just going to create a new user for test purposes. So this one can be john@superbase.com, and we can enter in a super secure password. And again, we'll auto confirm this user because we're just using it for test purposes. And we can create another user for thor@superbase.com and another super secure password and auto confirm this user. Now that we have some users, we can go back over to the table editor and associate some of our to-dos with specific authors. So we can just double click here, and this is going to look up all of the rows in the related table of auth.users. So we can scroll across and see this is our John@superbase user and this one's Thor. So let's say Thor authored this first post, and then our John user authored this second one. And then who should we pick for our third one? I shouldn't have made this an odd number. All right, let's just give it to Thor. And now each of our to-dos have an author. And if we go back to the SQL editor and select all of our to-dos again, we can see those authors for our to-dos. So what would this look like if one of our authenticated users tried to run this select query? Well, we can do that from the Superbase Studio. So if we change this role from the Postgres role, which has admin privileges and bypasses row level security, and instead change it to the authenticated role, meaning we can impersonate either of our users. So let's impersonate John. Now, if we run that same select query, we'll see success, no rows returned. So Thor gets two to-dos and John doesn't even get to see them anymore. Well, we can see even if we change this to stop impersonating John and instead impersonate Thor and run this same select query again, Thor can also not see any of the rows. And this is because when we set up our table, we enabled row level security or RLS but no policies have been created yet, and so we need to create a policy to allow access to this table. So by default, row-level security, or RLS, automatically denies any requests to this table. No one can select, insert, update, or delete any of the rows. If we want to enable one of those actions, we just need to write a policy. So let's create a new policy. There are some templates that we can use to get started, but let's create this one from scratch. The name of this policy is going to be users can select their own to-dos. This is going to enable the select action. We'll leave the target roles as the default, which is public. And then for this using expression, we need to provide an expression that evaluates to either true or false. If it's true, then the user will be able to select this row. And if it's false, RLS will continue denying it. So we want to check that the author column of this specific to-do contains the value of our current user. And so the way we get this value is with the auth.uid function. So this is a special Superbase function, which gives you back the ID of the user who's trying to perform this action. So let's scroll down to click review, which shows us the SQL that's been generated by each of these form fields. And then we can click save policy to run that against our Postgres database. Now, if we go back to the SQL editor and we again change our role to the authenticated role and impersonate one of our users and then run this select statement again, simulating this user being signed into an application that's making a request to Superbase, we can see our John user is only able to see that second to do because he is the author of that one. And if we were to change this to Thor, so let's stop impersonating John and impersonate Thor and run this select statement again, we can see Thor can very unfairly see both of his to-dos. And if we change this back to the Postgres role, which again bypasses row-level security policies, and run this select again, we can see all three of those to-dos come back because this is an admin user. So the RLS policy is acting like an implicit where clause on our select statement. It's filtering down the result set to just the to-dos that the signed-in user authored, but a quick optimization tip, you should always write an explicit where clause on the select statement rather than just relying on RLS. Not only does this make it more clear and explicit for anyone working on this code in the future, but it helps the Postgres query planner to optimize the result set that it's working with. So let's select star from to-dos where the author column is equal to the auth.uid function. And now if we run this as our Postgres role, we don't get any rows returned because auth.uid returns null. But if we change the role to our authenticated role and impersonate one of our users and run our select statement again, we'll see exactly the same result set, but the Postgres query planner is much happier with us, even though we're only working with three rows. But what if I don't want to write all this raw SQL myself? Can the robots help me out? Of course they can. So if we create a new query, we can ask Superbase AI to help us out by saying something like count the number of to-dos for each author and sort descending by count column. And then Superbase AI will have a little think about it. And then we get this nice diffing view where we don't have anything at the moment. And these are the lines that it's suggesting to add. So let's accept that change. And then this is selecting the author column and then counting the rows and aliasing it as count from our public.todos table. So public is the schema that our todos table exists within by default. We could actually remove this if we want, or we can just leave it as is. It's then doing what's called an aggregate function where it's grouping by a particular column, which in this case is author, and then ordering by that count column in descending order. So this looks right. Let's run it. And we're still impersonating our John user. So we only got that one row back that he's allowed to see. So let's go back to our Postgres role and then run this query again. And we can see that very unfair result set where our Thor user has two to-dos and our John user only has one. So now that we have our Superbase project, let's connect it to a Next.js app. But first, we need to talk about cookies and authorization. I recommend you check out this video right here, where we go through why you need to store sessions in cookies, especially in the Next.js app router. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.